Hi everyone, and thanks for watching. In this episode, I'd like to show you a little trick on how you can accentuate your 3D models, making them look a little bit more dimensional and adding a little pop to their design. So let's get started. I open a session of Aspire. It's going to be a single-sided, nominal size of whatever you choose, but as usual, my modeling resolution is set to very high. I'm going to bring in one of the items from our Clipart gallery. This trick can be done with a lot of different models. I'm going to choose the double heart model that comes with the software. As you know, simply double click on it or drag it in and adjust the size as needed. I also want to include a ribbon. I go to the folder where the ribbons are, and we'll just choose the first ribbon. Again, adjust the size as needed. I'm going to need to increase the base height of this ribbon so it shows fully on top of the hearts. So there we have it. Two components. The hearts and the ribbon. And it's not a bad look, except I would like it to look slightly different. I would like the ribbon to have a more natural flow to it. So, with that in mind, I select each of the components individually and I create a boundary vector. One for the heart and one for the ribbon. I'm going to drag down a guideline just to the bottom of the ribbon where it comes over the hearts. I'm going to grab another guideline and bring it to the top of the ribbon. This is the area that I'm going to fill with a new component. It's going to be a two-rail sweep project. So I take the heart vector, I'm going to offset it by an inch. How did I come up with an inch? A little bit of guesswork and a little playing around. You choose what would be best for you. I'm going to turn the heart component visible so I can create a cross-sectional profile of the heart right at those guidelines. That gives me the accurate shape that I need to work with. Now I need to create the rails for our true rail sweep based upon our offset vector. So I'm going to just enter into the node edit mode, hover over a node, hit the C key to cut it. You could see there's going to be a lot of nodes in that offset vector. So I simply click on both of the rails that we're going to be using, and I use the convert to curves, Bezier curve, so I can eliminate as many nodes as possible. When I'm done with that, I take a close look at our model profile, the cutaway view, and I'm going to create a new vector that's going to lay over top of it. It's going to simulate where the ribbon would actually fall. We think the ribbon is made out of a flexible material, like cloth, let's just say. And it wouldn't necessarily normally fit within those tight inner corners. To have a natural feel, you have to think about how that material is going to just lay on top of the hearts. Very gentle, very soft, with pockets underneath where those tight corners are. Again, your skill and speed of drawing vectors will make a difference. The more practice you have, the quicker and better and more accurate you can get. At this point, I'm going to select all the nodes in the vectors, smooth them out by hitting the S key, adjusting them appropriately. This is the top one. You can delete some nodes if you want to, add more nodes if you want to. The idea here is to make this new vector smooth and flowing, as a real piece of material would be if it was cloth. Now, obviously, if the banner was metal, different story. I'm going to select now my two rail sweep option. I click on the first rail on the left, hold the shift key, select the second rail on the right. I'm going to select my first profile and attach it to the first top of the rail. My second profile is going to be at the very bottom. I'm going to apply and close. And there's our new component that we're going to be working with. We can see in the 3D view immediately there's some sort of distortion. It's not an error. It's caused by an additional node that we didn't necessarily need. Now, I could have gone in and removed the node and ran the two rail sweep again, but since I already knew and anticipated I would be doing some sculpting, some smoothing, I decided to let it be and I can adjust it within the sculpting tool. You could take your time, you can go fast. This is part of the modeling process. That's the artistic side. I can only give you suggestions of what to do. You have to decide what looks best for you and your project. This could take a few minutes, or in some cases, it could take several hours. Don't be intimidated. I select that new component and the ribbon vector that we've created earlier, and I'm going to keep everything within that ribbon vector. That's our new component. I'm going to turn on the original ribbon plus our new component. I'm going to make a copy of that visible model. With that shown, that new model shown, as well as the heart, we're going to change its components to merge. We can see that it's sitting a little bit higher above the heart that we really would want. So I simply change the base height or the shape height to what looks comfortable. Again, this is at your discretion, your choice. It's your project. I just hope to give you the idea of how you can take something and alter it slightly. Now we take a look at it, rotate it around, looks more natural. As I've said, this is the original. It's not bad. This is my version of it. It's just different. A before and an after. Let's try something a little different. Open another session. We're going to import the rope border, the anchor, and the octopus. I'm going to add a zero plane as well. I'm going to create a boundary vector for the octopus. I'm going to hide the octopus and make a new model from our existing 3D view. With that model selected and the vectors for the octopus, I'm going to keep everything inside of the vectors of the octopus. I can take that new component into the sculpting and smooth a few things out. Turn back on our anchor, rope, and zero plane and the octopus, and you can see how different the octopus looks. It's subtle, but it's different. This is where now you get to choose how much impact you'd like to create. You can change the shape height of that new component. Not necessarily the shape height of the octopus, but just where it overlays over the anchor or the rope. and sometimes the end results could be rather dramatic. Again, this is just a small trick to help your work look slightly different from everybody else. Again, the before and the after. Subtle, but noticeable. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to learn more about the Vectric software, VCarve and Aspire, subscribe and you'll be informed when new videos come out. If you have any questions, send me an email. mm@mezalick.com. Enjoy.